In music, what's the smallest possible unit? What's the smallest thing we can break a song down into? A verse? A phrase? A motive? A note? Let's come back to this question in a moment. Today I want to talk about synthesis and what we need to think about when we're designing new synthesized sound. Now, I'd bet that everybody who's watching this video has interacted with a synthesizer in some way in their life. And there's nothing wrong with opening up a synth, going through the presets, and finding sounds that you like. But that's not really the type of synthesis that I'm talking about here. I'm talking about the ability to design your own sounds, whether it's to create unique musical instruments for a specific musical situation, or doing sound design for video games or other media. This demands a different level of attention to detail and examination of the individual components of a sound. So, for a definition, synthesis, simply put, is the design and production of audible waveforms through electronics. People have been doing this for over 100 years, starting with the early synthesizers, electronic musical instruments. At first, these instruments were analog, working directly with creating voltages. And nowadays, we could primarily say we synthesize sound digitally before transforming that digital information into voltage that we can hear. Now, there'll always be different things to learn depending on your system or software, but there are some fundamental ways to think about sound that can help you regardless of whether you're working in analog, digital, or even quantum computing. First and foremost is that synthesis rewards an attention to detail. To return to the question I opened this video with, I'm not sure what the real smallest musical unit is, but in synthesis and sound design, we need to engage with sound at a level that's smaller than an individual note. We need to think about how these sounds start, how they end, what happens over the course of a held note. Is there vibrato? Does the pitch change? Does the amplitude change? It's when we invest in these details ourselves that we can create sounds that are engaging for listeners too. A useful term, composer and author Curtis Rhodes defines microsounds as parts of sounds that are less than 1/10 of a second. Synthesis and sound design, in part, is an engagement with these microsounds. So, I advocate for a great deal of listening to help develop these skills. But since we're concerned with sound and music in a different way, this might mean learning new skills in how you listen to music. Once again, returning to this attention to detail, being able to shift your focus from the macro level of the song to the micro level of each individual sound. If we can think critically about these details of sound when we listen to others' work, it helps guide us when we create our own sounds. Along with this attention to detail, I believe a really strong understanding of the fundamentals of sound, acoustics, how sound is represented electronically, how it's represented digitally, gives us the tools to make good decisions in synthesis and to innovate in creating original sounds. Again, there are a lot of options of analog synthesizers, modular synthesizers, programming environments, synthesis environments, and to use any of them, you need to learn the peculiarities of that particular system. But these skills of listening and understanding the fundamentals of sound synthesis will allow you to take what you know and apply it to a variety of different systems and environments. 10 years from now, 20 years from now, I don't know what synthesis environments are going to be around. But I'm not worried because the fundamentals of how sound is produced, what sound is made up of, aren't going to change. And so I'm sure there'll be new types of synthesis, but this fundamental goal of designing audible waveforms through electronics is going to remain the same. And if we develop attention to detail, good listening skills, and understanding of fundamentals, we'll be prepared for whatever comes next.